Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired hematology priest, Christian Sikhism. We are going to give an exposition of Matthew 19, Parable of Marriage and Divorce, Part 5. Similarly, God has made soul the symbolic man to dominate over flesh, the symbolic woman. Now, this is, I'm giving the physical analogy. In spiritual senses, that the man is the Christ in your heart and the woman is the wisdom. And our wisdom should be a female, or should be a foolish to the wisdom of our Father God. So unless we make like that and we subdue our wisdom to that of God, then we remain virgin. But if we don't subdue our wisdom to our Father or do His will, as Christ Jesus said, He has come to do the will of our Father and not His own will. And that time His wisdom, which was same as the Holy Spirit was, it was virgin. So it was with the Son and it was virgin. So the same way we have to keep our wisdom virgin. So we have to be solitary following that narrow road. And when we do that, and we stay virgin. So this is just that our Christ should dominate the wisdom, not that somebody else come in, like Pope, give a sweet sermon and you follow him. That is not the way. Let your inner man, the Christ, dominate your wisdom. And he being the inner man, Christ being the seed of our Father God, he being the Son of God, then he will keep you virgin. Otherwise, if you are not led by your inner man, then somebody else will take you away. Or such people who have no Christ in their heart, or who are once born, they are like dead people. Anybody can drag them. So such once born people are also called corpses. And those people who are looking after these corpses are the people who want to make a following, like Pope is doing. So they are called vultures. So you see in Russia, when they open the door to the outside world, look how the vultures went there to get hold of the corpses, the dead people in Russia. They are simpletons and they could be followed, they could follow anyone because they are not spiritually alive, they are dead. So it is the Christ in you that is the man. And this Christ you receive by the grace of our Father. Otherwise you are just soul and water. So in the beginning, as you know, there was only the soul and water, the body, and the people over there, they were all saint. They got the Spirit of God, and they had the love of humanity. So in the beginning in their habits they were childlike. What is inside is outside. And they were united with each other. So it's only that when the temptation of the mammon or the other thing appears, as in Genesis the serpent appear, which is they are like serpent. Remember, John the Baptist called these temple priests the brood of vipers. So when such clever people appear as the temple priests who want to make a following, then your wife can, or your wisdom can be stolen by the others. And then when it leaves it, then you divorce your wife. Now I will come to that point later on. As I explained earlier, this parable is quite a difficult one, and it is for those who have ears to hear and to those whom it is given, because gospel is always received through revelation on individual basis. However, we share with other people and we do not impose our views, so let them form their own opinion. Similarly, God has made soul the symbolic man to dominate over flesh, the symbolic woman. Using this symbolic language, Jesus said, "For this cause shall a man, that is soul, leave father and mother." God is the father of all souls, who protects us, and Holy Spirit is our mother that enables us to perceive our Father through feeding to us His Word. And shall cleave mean the inseparable union to His wife. His wife flesh, and they twain, soul and flesh, shall be one flesh or person. Now this spiritual principle of marriage is just the opposite of the moral code of marriage, in which it is the wife that leaves her mother and father, that is the bride, is given away in the marriage by her father to join her husband, just the other way. Further, this spiritual marriage between the soul and the flesh, dictated by Christ Jesus, takes place in the very womb of the woman, on her conception of the baby, whereas the moral marriage between a boy and a girl takes place outside in the physical world, So this is a physical side of the marriage. So man leaves his mother and father. You know, the man that represents the seed of the father, and that is the Son of God. So when you have Son of God in you, then you have Christ in you. So then you subdue your wisdom to the wisdom of our Father, and then your wisdom is a virgin one. If you follow Pope or other one, then it's no more virgin, but it has become a prostitute. So only the Christ in you will lead the virgin wisdom through the narrow gate, which is only one person can pass, can enter. That means will make you solitary. On solitary basis you enter the royal kingdom of God. Not that you enter together, but all those who are in the royal kingdom of God, although they are solitary, but they are of one accord, one opinion. So this, as the moral codes of marriage have exceptions, in that if the father of the girl is dead, then her uncle can give her away in the marriage, whereas the spiritual principles of God, the marriage have no exception. So the spiritual one, has no exception. The physical moral laws have the exceptions. So the marriage which Christ Jesus is describing has no